Hello students, once again a very warm welcome. So in today's class I am going to talk about one disease which is a malaria. Yes, you're right, I'm talking about a disease which is caused by protozoa, which is a plasmodium. So in today's class I'm going to talk about the life cycle of plasmodium. Before discussing about this life cycle of plasmodium, I would like to give you a brief introduction of plasmodium. So please have a look. So we are talking about protozoan disease, that is malaria. That is malaria. Question arises, who causes malaria? So malaria is caused by plasmodium. Obviously when we are talking about a protozoan disease, that means this plasmodium is a protozoan. Is it right? Now this plasmodium which causes malaria, this is not the only species which causes malaria. There are other species also, like other than the this plasmodium, the different species which is present, that is a plasmodium falciparum, plasmodium ovale, plasmodium malariae. Let's talk about each of these. So first let's talk about plasmodium falciparum. Plasmodium falciparum, it causes malaria, and this is that malaria which is not curable. So this is a most deadly form. So the disease which is caused by it, this is termed as, because I need a space, so let me write this thing on the one side so that I can write incubation period as well, the fever cycle as well, so that the things will be more clear to you. Now let's talk about the plasmodium falciparum. Right? So this causes malignant tertian fever. Malignant tertian fever or malignant tertian malaria. Now in this case, now let's talk about its incubation period. Incubation period. Now you all must be wondering about the incubation period. Incubation period is that period, that is a period between an infection and the appearance of first symptom. Suppose this plasmodium has entered in my body, there will not be a simultaneous symptom. It will take time. The whole infection time, that is termed as a incubation period, right? And for the plasmodium falciparum, that is incubation period is around 9 to 14 days, right? And in this case, yes, I'm going to talk about the fever cycle also. Fever cycle. Now what is a fever cycle? In this case, the fever, there is a recurrent fever, and for the plasmodium falciparum, the recurrent fever timing is 36 to 48 hours. 36 to 48 hours. Let's talk about the second one, that is plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax. So this is another species and it causes another type of fever which is termed as benign tertiary fever. Benign tertiary fever. Now in this case the incubation period is different, that is around 13 to 15 days. And fever comes after 48 hours. So there is a recurrent fever. This is a second species. Let's talk about the third species, that is Plasmodium malariae. Plasmodium malariae. This Plasmodium malariae, it causes quartan fever. Quartan fever. Right? In this case, the incubation period, that is around 28 to 30 days. And fever cycle is 72 hours. Let's talk about the fourth, the last one, Plasmodium ovale. So Plasmodium ovale, it causes mild tertiary malaria. Mild tertiary malaria. Now in this case, the incubation period is around 14 days, right? And the fever cycle is again of 48 hours. So these are the different type of species which causes malaria. Now in this case, malaria is not caused because of this Plasmodium. Yes, it is caused because of Plasmodium, but they require certain vector, and that vector is a mosquito. So in this case, there are two hosts. Let's talk about it. The first thing is, malaria is caused by female Anopheles carrying this protozoan. So when a female Anopheles bite on our body which carries this protozoan, they releases this protozoan in our body. When they release this protozoan in our body will show malaria. Is it clear to you? So in that respect, as per the malaria is considered, there are two different hosts. Let's talk about them. So host. So first host is termed as an intermediate host. Intermediate host. Intermediate host is that host in which this protozoan completes asexual cycle. So protozoan show asexual cycle. That means they reproduce by asexual method, and for this the host is human or other primate. So this is not only a disease of human, other primate, they also suffer from this disease. Now the second type of host in this case, that is termed as definitive host. Definitive host. Right? And definitive host is that host in which this protozoan completes sexual cycle. Sexual cycle. Right? And what is that host? That is a female Anopheles. female Anopheles. Is it clear to you? So this is a general introduction of the protozoan disease, which is malaria. It is caused by plasmodium. There are different species of plasmodium. It is actually caused by certain kind of vector, and that vector is a female Anopheles. So female Anopheles is also a host. And what kind of host? That is a definitive host, because in this case this organism shows the sexual cycle, whereas the intermediate host, these are those hosts in which this protozoan completes its asexual cycle, and that is a human and other primate. Now let's talk about its cycle. Come to the side, students. As you can see, this is a whole cycle. Now this cycle, I have divided the cycle into two different phases. Now first cycle I have shown in case of mosquito, and the second is cycle in case of human. Suppose a female Anopheles carrying this protozoan, and basically it is the sporozoid which is present in their salivary gland. Once it bites us, in that case what happens is these sporozoids, they are released in our blood. The sporozoids circulate in our blood for about half an hour. After that they enter into the liver cell. They go to liver or the hepatic cell, they enter over there, and once they enter in them, they causes certain changes, they causes destruction over there. There is a formation of hypnozoid, a schizont is formed, and after this schizont, all these merozoids, they are released. These merozoids, once they are released, now they are ready for causing infection in other liver cells, and also they can enter into the blood. Now listen very carefully. The whole cycle in which they show infection in the liver cell, this is termed as pre-erythrocytic schizogony. Pre-erythrocytic schizogony, right? In this case, there is formation of cryptomerozoites, etc. and etc. And once these merozoites, they are released, once they have shown the whole infection, they are ready that now they can enter into RBC. Now, once they enter into RBC, erythrocyte, this is a RBC, red blood cells. So once they enter into it, there is a formation of one stage which is termed as a signet ring stage. Signet ring stage. So signet ring stage is a stage just like a diamond on a ring. So this is how a signet ring stage look like. After that, there is a formation of amoeboid stage also, and they also show the formation of toxic chemical, that is a hemozoan crystals. So they also show the hemozoan crystal. So after some time, these erythrocytes, they burst, and there is a release of this toxic chemical, which is a hemozoan, that is hemozoan. So once these hemozoan, they are released into blood, it causes infection, it causes fever. Now listen very carefully. Now after that, from these erythrocyte, the gametocytes comes out. The gametocytes comes out. Now these this is a ruptured erythrocyte. From these erythrocytes, these are the gametocyte. One will act as a female gametocyte, other will act as a male gametocyte. This whole cycle, now it has affected the two different structure. The first was the liver and the second is a RBC. So this is termed as a erythrocytic schizogony. Erythrocytic schizogony. Is it clear? Now this erythrocytic schizogony, once it is completed, once these gametocytes are released into blood, suppose another female Anopheles comes and bite on this particular individual who is already suffering from malaria. In that case, once these insects that come on it, they sit on the skin, they try to suck the blood. In that case, these gametocytes will enter into the body of this mosquito. Once these gametocytes, it will enter into the body of mosquito, they will enter into its digestive system. That digestive system, the part is a midgut. That part is a midgut. The cycle which was occurring in case of human, that was an asexual cycle. This was a asexual cycle. Now it's time for the sexual cycle. Now these gametocytes, it will grow and it will form the two different type of gamete. One will be termed as a macrogamete, that will act as a female gamete, and another will be a microgamete, which will be a male gamete. So this is how both of them will be formed. Now what will happen? This microgamete, it will attach itself to the macrogamete. Now there will be formation of a zygote. Obviously fertilization will happen and there will be formation of zygote. Now the next stage is the formation of oocinate. This oocinate will cross the mosquito midgut and it will enter into the salivary gland. Salivary gland of mosquito. Now what will happen? In the case in between these oocinate, there will be development of large number of these sporozoids. Then the oocinate will burst. All these sporozoids, it will be released in the saliva, along with the saliva. When this mosquito, it will bite any individual or any primate, now this will cause malaria. So earlier, this Anopheles was not carrying malaria. Once it has bite, once it has taken up the gametocytes from the person who is infected with the malaria, it will show the protozoan in their body, and once they will bite another woman or other men who is not suffering from malaria, they will also suffer from malaria. So this is how the whole cycle begins. Actually, this pre-erythrocytic schizogony is a very big schizogony. For detail, you can refer to our session. This was just a general introduction regarding the topic malaria. All about the today's session. Hope the things are clear to you. Next session, I'll be discussing more. Take care of yourself. Thank you so much, students, for watching this.